Hello everyone, welcome back. As you can see, we are in full spectrum and we are at 9 wins. Remember before when I said that this deck didn't have a good finisher? Well, it turns out, Steven Skellen into Selkirk, fantastic finisher. Especially when combined with Dandelion and Resurrect, I can set up for whatever finisher I want on top. Igni is probably the most risky card in the deck, but it's already won a couple matches. It's especially good against Shoop. The big thing that destroys this deck is Shillard. Because Steven Skellen is so good that he sets things on top, I think that most decks should at least run one Shillard, just in case, in order to defeat your opponent when they use Steven Skellen. The various Scorch effects in my decks have been very useful so far. I haven't had to use an offensive Vilgax Force yet. Let's see if that will change now that we're on the final win. All right, this should be interesting. So we have an opponent who's able to choose what cards they have in their hand. They essentially have an ability similar to ours. Ermion is one of the weak cards in our deck, so is Peter. Cadaverine, easy thing to give up. I'm surprised that the bottom of my screen is appearing that way. I'm not sure exactly why it's doing that. If you'll excuse me one second. It looks like my settings will be put into disarray this time. We don't have the time for that. So welcome back. Let's see how to make this work. Yeah. I think I'm going to set up this. Go into the bear. This way, if I draw something like the restore later, it won't be much problem. I maybe should have waited there because I have a good weather clear, but I don't have a very good weather clear. So I'll assume... Generating, a surprising amount of points just in that play alone. Wow. 11 points will be hard to make up. Let's see if I can do this to generate something palpable. So this is 8 damage to a non-monster faction unit. That will immediately generate me 14 points, getting me 3 points ahead. So that's probably my best bet. The rest of these, not good enough. Yep. Let's do this. Let's see if my opponent can have what it takes. The only reason I'm playing here now is 1, because I have Caretaker, 2, because I have... Because I have interesting options available to me. Do I want to kill this Standard Bearer? He does look rather pretty. I would like to murder him. Not the pretty people. I'll just do this. Yeah. Haha. I imagine that this will save me roughly 12 points overall. This way it can save my my wonderful Mr. Man here, Selkirk, for something a little bit stronger, preferably in the 11 range, as he did. If I draw Steven Skellen, that would be ideal too, because then I could put Selkirk in my deck for any given situation, really. Since I'm 7 points ahead, if I get about 15 to 20 points ahead, I will drop... I will drop what I'm doing and just let him proceed forward. But for now... He has 2 weak creatures out in the field. I don't really want to drop my dragon. If he plays something that's literally 18 points in a single unit, I'm going to drop Villain Dreadnought. If he plays something like Tibor, I don't know what I'll do then, to be honest. Interesting choice. Alright. So now I have he has a unit stronger than mine on the field. So it's possible for me to play this dragon. Though probably not very wise. There's not really much for Coral to be used on. And I think Coral is actually pretty bad for this mode. Not a lot of people run very strong bronzes. I seem to be the only one who picked up Osril or Ghoul. She has come in handy every so often, but I'd say majority of the cases you don't really want Coral in this mode. Let's go with Villain Trentonriff and see what he does. I'm committed to 3 rounds now. But I'm okay with that. I can just do this, this, and this, or this, this, and this, and whatever this draws. Or coral, obviously. Villain Threat and Rift is probably only going to get 7 points, but if my opponent is not content, yes. Since they don't have to worry about tempo, they just choose to get what they wish. Probably going to kill the Villain Threat and Rift. Sets up for a double Scorch, but that's okay. I realize I screwed up. How did I not notice this? Oh well. Okay, I pretty much just chose that as an act of desperation. As I do... I don't need to act in desperation here since he played a 10-point card. So I can play this card out fully. Now, if he has a method of killing this thing, he should take it. Yes. Good. So he has two of these. That's very interesting. Well, I'm finding a 9-strength deck, so that shouldn't be too surprising for me. If I play this, I get to... I can deal with the sucker here, but it's actually equally good to get the Ale of the Ancestors since this is no longer available. Yeah, I'm gonna do sucker here. Okay, this could set up an interesting situation. So the best thing I can do for my own sanity is play Vilgefortz on one of these in order to get something from my deck, but this is not allowing me to play into the long game. I think I've overcommitted in this round already, so I will likely die. Coral is useless here. If I play him, he is essentially worth 13 points. My opponent will get ahead by 1. So really the only option here is to pass, giving my opponent even, or to Vilgefortz. I think I'd like to Vilgefortz. Interesting. No! I didn't choose it fast enough. I was gonna choose Reamed. So that was 12 points plus 4, 16 points, so I have to make 14 points up overall. That's still not enough for Migdebras. I would have to risk Vreemd in order to play on. Or lose 2 cards. I'm unwilling to do that. I have to give up here. Vreemd usually generates 12 points on average. That was a monumental loss. And it was because of the... was it because of that? Not really. Oh, those are both great cards, though. Unless he has Tybor or something like that, in which case I can't use her for her intended purpose. Oh well, I'm gonna go to card down in round 3 unless he chooses to play this out, which he didn't. So that would have been 12 points, yeah. What I expected. Probably could have looked at the other two. One of them might have been worth 14, but I don't think it was. I definitely don't want you. Fantastic. Okay. I think I'm gonna lose this one, pretty sure. But 9 wins, man. Hard to get. Now, what do I want to risk here? If I use the Resurrection, I can get up to 18 points, 19 points with Selkirk. If I use Villain Trentonmirth and he can't kill it, no matter what strong thing that he plays, I can kill it. However, if he has Shoop or anything of that matter, he'll win. I think I need to do this. He has 4 cards to make up 20 points. I can use Vilgefortz to kill my own dude. And it looks like that's the best option for me. Do I have anything that requires damage? Surprisingly, almost all my cards, except for Reconnaissance, will be okay. I lied. Not all my cards. There were 2 cards in my deck that were bad. Actually, Deathmold was also bad, so 3 cards out of 7. Or 3 cards out of 8. That's almost half. So I guess that's fair. Yeah, if he doesn't win this one, I will be very surprised. He's 2 cards to make up 16 points. Average card in this mode, probably 14 points. Damn. Slammed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 18. Okay, last chance. Hello, everyone. I lost the last attempt in a 9-win match. So this is my final chance. Get 9 wins this time. No matter what happens, you're going to be able to see this last attempt. I hope you find me worthy. The music that's playing is Ramsey's Beat there for you. And let's see if I'm here to beat them. I have 2 Weather Clears in my hand. If I play first, I can pass with these 2. Pretty clearly. I can play Stefan Skellen in the second round. Breamed is probably the worst card in my hand. Luckily, I can play on. Damn, if I had thought about it, I would have put Selkirk back just to boost him. Luckily, I still can do that. Question is, what do I want to sacrifice? Geralt Igni is probably the best card that I could sacrifice. If I don't want to sacrifice the Archbishop, which is the obvious choice. No. Let's play succinctly. I have a Weather Clear. And Trentonmirth and Osril are both out. I have a method of killing them, so let's do this. It's my turn. I'm going second. I think I have about a 30% chance of winning here, unless my opponent is just engrossed with weather. Enriched with weather. Let's see what you choose, sir. It took me a while. Mr. Palangchi. You choose what I'm going to choose. But I'm going to choose it a little bit later. No matter what, I think this is the right thing to do. Put you away, I'll grab you later. I have a scorch effect, a scorch effect, a scorch effect, and potentially another scorch effect if I draw. I shouldn't call this a scorch effect. Oh! Is that to reveal? That'd be interesting if that was the case. I'll assume that that is a 16-point to reveal, in which case this is very interesting indeed. And I can see why others would lose to him. Oh! A Morin. Fantastic. Do I have a Peter in my hand? I do not. My Peter is missing. My Peter should be on full display. What should I murder? Well, this seems obvious. Let's see how he reacts. Oh no, I'm sorry. This seems obvious because I want to get that card up now. What are you going to do? Interesting choice. I quite approve of it, actually. The question is, should I kill your Morin right now? No, because I'm waiting for my dragon. But what can I do? Let's see how this will work. This is a 9-point card, so in total that was 13. Above average. There are no spies, so let's do this. If he has a weather, now would be the time to use it. I think I'm going to summon the Bear Master now, because that way I get a huge unit on the field, and he has to dedicate more resources. And more than likely his unit will die, and I'll be able to steal it. If he can deal 8 damage to my bear, then he'll be able to deal a significant amount of damage with his... Wow! That was huge! I probably lost off of that. Interesting. I didn't realize all my units were bronze. That was a fantastic maneuver on his part. Shit. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be able to make up that. That's just too much. But, gotta try. I chose to do that simply because the consistent damage, I think I did that as a mistake, to be honest, now that I'm thinking about it. But I will be able to resurrect and kill this if I so wish. There's no way that this thing is not going to go down. I lied. There's several ways I can think of that that thing won't go down. I just would really like it to. Let's see if my humble little deck will manage to survive. Interesting. Choose to kill my bear. I would not say that I would agree with that decision. So spells make this awkward, because it's awkward to make interesting plays. I think that they figured that out more so than I did, but I'll have to work with what I got. Hmm. I need to kill one of his units. That's pretty clear. One of his silver. Might as well make it Morin. Yeah, I need to enable my caretaker. Well, that's not going to happen unless I do that, but I can wait till later. If he presents a better target, because reviving Morin isn't that good. All I really need is a 9 strength creature to get on the field, that or less, that has decent abilities. I don't think that this is as impossible as I thought it was, since I'm only down by 7. But the tempo of this deck is just so huge. The worst case scenario is... I guess it would be a 22-point Triss off of the Vilgefortz would be my finisher. So depending on what I have to attack with Vilgefortz would depend upon what I do there. So that's a wonderful card for me. I would love to get that card. And because they put it on the back row, I can actually do this efficiently. Let's do this. And then both of them will die, and now I have something for my caretaker to do. And I can kill that Morin if I wish. I don't think he's going to play an Igni, though. Of course. Of course you have Letho. Oh, well. I have enough to make this powerful. But do I want to cure the weather? Yes, I do. I'm catching up! This time I think it's just because of the strength of my cards. So I'm saving him because I would like to clear weather if he uses it. There's really no other reason for it. He's weakening my cards, which is rather nice for me. But not nice enough, unfortunately. I'm going to have to enable Igni here, I think. Yeah, the only other thing I can do is just tie. Let's do this. I mean, I guess I could have played, I could eat in the 10 and put it on the middle row, and that would have protected against Igni, if he had it. I maybe should have considered that. Yeah, because then I could protect against Igni altogether. So that would have been a smarter play. It would have been 1 point less, though. So if this round is decided by 1 point, that would have been a foolish play. Oh, okay. Works for me. Now you have enabled Igni for me. So Igni is not useless. I'm going to wait and see if there's something else I can do. So do I want to revive the villain Trentonmirth? I'm only going to do that if it looks like there's no other way to win other than scorching something huge. But since there's already a scorch target on the board, I think that just saving my Igni for last will be a pretty good way to win. Yeah. And I can just... I can get 5 points off of this. So that should work out okay. So I don't want to hit anything in the back here. Really, that just means that I want to... I guess hit... you. Why not? There's a good reason why I shouldn't have done that. I should have attacked the dwarf. I'm an idiot, because now I enable his scorch. If he had a scorch effect, I just enabled it. Yep. He couldn't play that villain Triton Rift. I just killed myself. If I lost, this is my fault. Fuck. I might have to offensive Vilgefortz and hope for the best. That was so stupid. Wow, okay. Yeah, I'm going to need to. I just lost. That maneuver that I said, why not, just cost me the game. That's extremely frustrating. No! I ran out of time. And it chose a target for me. That was... Oh my god. No! 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 This is the way I'm gonna lose? This right here? You motherfucker! Oh, god damn it. If I just killed this... Well, goodbye everyone. I hate everything. Goodbye. Fuck. Oh. I had it. I had it. I would have won. And now you know why order is important in Gwent. Oh my god. That was infuriating. Oh, that was wonderful. I hope you all enjoy this as much as I do. That was great. Order is important. And paying attention to what's the strongest thing on the board is always important. Goodbye, everyone.